Hello friends, welcome to Science Jagat. So today we will be discussing another important topic, that is edible vaccines. So before starting with edible vaccine, we should know what actually a vaccine is. So a vaccine is a biological preparation that provides immunity to a particular disease. Initially this word vaccine was derived from a Latin word that means veca, which means cow, and it was used for cowpox. So vaccine is one of the safe and effective way to control various infectious diseases. So before jumping to edible vaccine, we should know what are the types of vaccine. So basically there are two types of vaccine, one is prophylactic and another one is therapeutic. So prophylactic are to prevent the effects of a future infection by a natural or wild pathogen like conventional vaccines we are using. Another one is therapeutic, it is a vaccine which is used against cancer. So if we are talking about a vaccine, what ideal properties should a vaccine have? It should have low level of side effects, it should not be toxic or pathogenic, it should not cause problems in individuals, it should not contaminate the environment, the technique of vaccination should be quite simple, and it should be cost effective also. So what are edible vaccines? Edible vaccines are nothing but a vaccine that can be consumed orally, or it's a needle-free approach. So the term edible vaccine was initially used by Charles Anson in 1990. See, these vaccines were developed with the potential for generating affordable vaccines that would be easy to administer orally for impoverished populations in the developing world. So let's simplify this language. Let's have an idea that approximately 20% of the infants still miss the vaccination, and about 2 million unnecessary deaths are there each year because of the constraints of vaccines, which is production, distribution and delivery. That means the vaccines are produced but they are not in reach of that people that are impoverished populations and those who can't afford that. I agree that most of the vaccines are provided by the government, but the data is there that they can't reach the populations. So their use in many parts of the world is limited because of their high cost. The alternative to this high cost medicines are edible vaccines. Edible vaccines are nothing but antigenic proteins that are genetically engineered into a consumable crop. After consumption, the protein is recognized by the immune system. It elicits the immune response against the particular disease or the particular pathogen. So what are the production strategies for edible vaccines? So there are basically two production strategies. One is the expression of foreign antigen in plants via stable transformation, and another one is the delivery of vaccine epitope via plant virus. So this diagram depicts the production strategies. In this diagram, there are two notations, that is one is A1 and another one is B1. In A1, you can see they are using agrobacterium mediated genetic transformation, and another one is B1, they are using virus approach. So the epitope fusion to create a chimeric gene to viral coat protein. It is infected with a modified virus and then it is infected into the tobacco plant, and isolation of chimeric viral particles, and then it is studied in animals. In another approach, agrobacterium mediated gene transformation is there and the transgenic plants were regenerated. After stable integration of gene into nuclear chromosomes, the extraction of the foreign antigen is there and the feeding of edible plant tissues is there. So it's a long process. Tissue culture approach is also used there. There are stable transformation approaches should be there. And for gene delivery, there could be many approaches like agrobacterium or ballistic or gene gun could also be used. So what is the mode of action mode of action of an edible vaccine. So the goal of oral vaccine is to stimulate both mucosal and humoral immunity against pathogens. So an antigen produced in the edible part of a plant can serve as a vaccine against agents which invade epithelial membranes. Peyer's patches are enriched sources of immunoglobulin A, producing plasma cells and populate mucosal tissues. So this is the basic idea that how they are working. What about targeting strategy? The targeting strategy is to attach antigens to the cells that bind M cells in the intestine lining. Then the M cells take in materials that enter intestine and pass them down to the other cells like APCs. Then the macrophages degrade proteins and antigens into fragments and display them in cell surface. When T lymphocytes recognize the foreign fragments, they trigger the release of antibodies and helps in bigger attack of cells. So what are the candidates of edible vaccine? So we have learned that what are the production strategies, what is the mode of action. So we should have some edible crops, or you can say plants, that can work as candidates for edible vaccines. It could be banana, potato, tomato, rice, wheat, soybean, corn, etc. So these candidates which we have discussed have their own advantages and disadvantages. Like if we talk about banana, the advantage is it do not need cooking. Protein is not destroyed even after cooking. It is inexpensive and grown in developing countries. Its disadvantages: trees takes 2-3 years to mature. Like banana has a very long life cycle, so the maturity time is quite larger. And it spoils rapidly after ripening, like you can't store banana for too much longer time. Another one is potato. It is easily transformed, easily propagated, stored for longer periods without refrigeration. Like we never store potatoes in refrigerator. The disadvantage is this: we can't eat potato raw, we have to cook it, and once we are cooking the potato, the antigen could be denatured. Next one is tomato. It grows quickly. It is cultivated broadly. It has higher content of vitamin A, which also boosts the immune response. And its disadvantages: it spoils readily. Next one is rice, and we all know that rice is one of the most important staple crop all over the world, and it could be given to many people in order to provide vaccine. Like we can transform rice. So it have advantages like commonly used in baby food, high expression of antigen. And if we talk about the disadvantage, it grows slowly, like it's having the life cycle of approximately 4 to 5 months, and it requires glasshouse conditions. Examples of edible vaccines: that edible vaccines are produced in many plants and for so many number of diseases. One is hepatitis B virus. It is vectors used for potato, tobacco, lettuce. In some plants it is produced, and it is used against hepatitis B. Norovirus virus, rabies virus, transmissible gastroenteritis, corona virus, rabbit hemorrhage disease virus, HIV virus, and vibrio cholerae. So there are so many edible crops which are used, like potato, lettuce, tobacco, maize, etc. And if you see this chart, tobacco is mostly used, but we know that tobacco also has its disadvantages. So there are so many factors which affect the efficacy of edible vaccine. Factors are antigen selection, choice of plant species, like which plant species we are choosing for producing the edible vaccine, or efficacy of model system, which model system we are using for production. What are the related safety issues? How we are delivering this, and what are the dosing? Like if I provide some banana to a population, that this banana is containing an edible vaccine. If I distribute that banana in a particular population, then how could we regulate the dosage? If a person eats one or two banana, then we would not be able to regulate the dosage. We have to maintain the dosage, which is quite difficult in case of edible vaccines. Also, quality control is also one of the important concern. So there are major advantages of edible vaccines, like it is cost effective in comparison to conventional vaccines, easy to administer, like we don't need needles for it, easy to store. So it has some dilemma, like is it really easy to store? Like for bananas, tomatoes, we need refrigeration. Acceptable to poor developing country, yes, we agree with that. It's heat stable, activate both mucosal and systemic immunity. Another, we have the disadvantages. It's not convenient for infants. Like to an infant, we can't give a banana or a raw potato or a tomato. Stability of vaccine in fruit is still not known. That we don't know whether the vaccine is stable in the fruit. Dosage of vaccine would be variable, as I have already discussed. People may develop allergy, like some people are having allergy for particular foods, and its consistency also varies. So friends, thanks for listening. If you like our video, please do like and subscribe our channel, and please share it also. Thanks for listening. We will be back soon with another important topic. Thank you so much.